Good morning, friends. Sunday morning, podcast time with Brother Mike. Thank you for tuning in, and may God bless you today. I'm Brother Mike. I'm the counselor at the Arizona Deliverance Center in Phoenix. We're on 15th Avenue, just south of Indian School Road. It's the red brick building. When you visit the services, Thursday and Friday nights at 7 p.m. Arizona and Pacific time. We have preaching, teaching, healing, and deliverance at both of those services. Both of them are broadcast live on our YouTube teaching channel, among other platforms. YouTube.com/House of Healing AZ, assuming YouTube hasn't canceled us. But if they do, we're on several other platforms. You can catch us there. If you need to get a hold of me, just send me an email, mike@hardcorechristianity.com. I get lots and lots of emails, and I answer all of them. I send an answer to every one of my emails, so no matter how long it takes me, hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, whatever it is, I just keep plowing through it. I'll be in Carlsbad, California at the Senior Center. I am a senior citizen. I know that's hard to believe. I'm an old man, but I'll be at the Carlsbad Senior Citizen Center this Saturday. Okay, we're having a 4 hour service there. Look on the website, hardcorechristianity.com. Just click the calendar button at the top, boop, and all the information is right there. We will see you there next Saturday. I hope you're able to join us. Some of the ministry team is coming to the service as well. Thank God for them. Appreciate their help. You can, if you're in the Phoenix area, you can call the ministry line. If you need to set up a counseling appointment, there's no charge for born-again Christians. 602-636-5800 is the ministry line to set up a counseling appointment if you happen to be in Maricopa County. And again, there's no charge to born-again Christians. May God richly bless you. I wanted to tell you a story. I told you this story a few years ago. After I first started my Christian counseling practice, as I mentioned, I was a secular counselor for 25 years, and God had me transition out of that into Christian counseling. And in 2005, I had been open for only a few months. And a woman came to see me from a very large, famous prophetic ministry here in the Valley. Phoenix is the second hottest spot for prophetics in the United States. Redding in California is the number one hot spot, but Phoenix is number two. We have a couple of very large prophetic ministries here in the Phoenix area. Well, this, I had never been involved with prophetics before, other than I had attended a few of their services. I'd gone to a couple of their seminars in different places. I had seen Patricia King. I saw Todd Bentley and so on. A woman came to me for counseling, and this was in 2005, the beginning of the summer. And this, after my initial interview of her, she seemed like a really great person. She was, she loved the Lord. She was a very likable person. She had been serving in this large prophetic ministry in the Valley for, you know, several months. Didn't seem to have, had no mental illnesses for sure. She didn't have, seem to have any significant emotional problems. You know, she had some issues with her mother, as I recall, or somebody like that. But I thought, well, this is going to go pretty smoothly. So I took her into the prayer room. And I started to pray some casual prayers. And to my utter amazement, this woman started to manifest powerful spirits. Her body started shaking, jumping up and down on the prayer bench. She was laying down praying. All kinds of strange stuff started happening, and I was kind of taken aback by it. I was shocked. I'd never seen that happen before and didn't know anything about it. And she went through some massive, powerful deliverance that I wasn't expecting. But when I saw that this was kind of sovereignly happening and I was not involved in it, I saw the Holy Ghost just move on her. I jumped in with both feet, of course, and I played it on out right to the end. And about an hour later, it was over. And she said that she couldn't believe that those spirits were in her. She did not know that. She felt so different, so relieved, so light. On and on she went, and so on. Well, anyway, to shorten the story up, she went back to this prophetic ministry, told them what happened, and then from that moment on, all summer long, I had these people coming in, and I was booking them in, 3 and 4 people a day. I was taking 3 or 4 counseling appointments a day. This was in 2005 when I had a lot more energy and I was a lot younger. I couldn't believe it. And it was the same story practically, not in every case, but practically. They seemed to be good people. They loved the Lord. They were in ministry. They were doing good things. And they had these incredible, strange spirits that were heavy manifestors. And I noticed that many of them had basic spirits and sin in their life that should have been repented of, the normal stuff you repent of after you become a Christian. A lot of them hadn't repented of it, but they were already in the ministry. And they were already doing a good job in the ministry. And this went on literally all summer long, the entire summer. I was casting these strange demons, which caused me to research it, and I came up with it. They were Kundalini spirits from Africa. And to make a longer story short, I put in an enormous amount of time researching it and studying it, and I found out what had happened. These African spirits, Kundalini spirits, had invaded the Toronto Blessing, and they had infected all the people at the Toronto Blessing. And that's the manifestations, the strange ones, were occurring all through that revival. People were doing crunches, severe jerking, hysterical laughing, barking like dogs, moving around on the floor like a snake, different things, all kinds of strange manifestations. And the people running the Toronto Blessing, they were really good people. Randy Clark is a beautiful man. Arnaud's, they were fantastic people. They had no idea what they were and didn't understand it. So they just made an assumption, which turned out to be deadly. They assumed it was God. All the manifestations were God. Some guy barking, God. Some guy slithering, God. Hysterical laughter, rolling around, backflips, God. All of it, crunches, sit-ups, everything, God. They just assumed it was God because, number one, they couldn't figure it out. And number two, if they said anything about it, it was going to cause a split or a divide in the revival, and they didn't want to disrupt it. So from the Toronto Blessing all over the United States, these spirits infected the charismatic churches. They don't infect churches like Episcopals, Lutherans, and Methodists, and so on. The demons already have them bagged. They can't manifest in those kind of services because those people don't believe or follow anything like that. They only attack Pentecostals and Charismatics. And Pentecostals and Charismatics, because they have, in many cases, an emotionally based religion and a sense-based religion, they will welcome in these spirits, and it is a cataclysmic disaster. It's a disaster. I've been casting these Kundalini spirits out of thousands of people since 2005. I have had thousands of people come in for counseling or come to the live services that have had these Kundalini spirits. Now, these demons from Africa, they're extremely intelligent, and they mimic the Holy Spirit, but they're not using the spirit man. They're using the person's soul. They give them soulish, good feelings, emotions, sensations. They give them cold and hot sensations in their body. They cause the body to shake, you know, they shake, rattle, and roll. They give the person like sensations they like, sensations they enjoy. And the person is deceived because it feels good. They come in with a glory cloud. Oh, it feels great. Let's cheer. Let's do backflip. Let's party. They make statues bleed. Oh, the stat Mother Mary's got it. She's bleeding. Oh, that's amazing. Look, there's a statue with oil coming out of it. Oh, that is wonderful. And then they lead the person to all kinds of weird doctrines, like Christian Ouija boards and Christian tarot cards and different supposedly discernment methods of helping the person get closer to God and so on. Well, when I first started researching these demons, I couldn't believe it. They are in the Word of God. The Corinthians church got invaded by Kundalini spirits. Here it is. If you go to, the Galatian church, the Galatians in chapter 1, listen to this. Paul says, quote, I marvel. That's the Greek word phamazo. It means I'm shocked. I'm in a state of shock that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ to another gospel. The Greek word for another there is heteros. Heteros means something that's totally different from something else. For example, you have an apple and an orange. That's heteros. They're two totally different fruit. Then Paul says in verse 7, Galatians 1, which there is not another gospel. Although there are some who are troubling you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. Now the Greek word for another in that verse is different from the word another in the previous verse. It's not heteros, it's allos. Allos means something of a similar kind and quality. For example, you have a red apple and a green apple. They're both apples, but they're just different. Heteros means you would have an apple and an orange, totally different fruits, unrelatable. They're both fruits, but they're totally different ones. Allos means they're both apples. They're similar. One of them's red, one of them's green. Jesus used another comforter in the Gospel of John. He used allos for the Holy Spirit and himself. I'm going to send you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Allos meaning something of a similar kind and quality. Holy Spirit, Jesus, similar. Heteros, Holy Spirit, demons, totally different, no connection. And Paul says there isn't another gospel similar to the one that you receive. There's only one gospel. That's it. There's not another one that is truly similar to it. It's unique of its kind and quality. But he says there's some people coming in troubling you. Tarasso means to agitate or cause a division or cause headbuttings. And there's some in coming in to pervert the gospel of Christ. And then he says, though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel, which we haven't preached. The Greek word for preach there is karasso, proclaim, to proclaim the gospel. Let them become accursed, anathema. As I told you before, I'm saying again, if any man preach another gospel, any other gospel than what you receive from us, he is cursed. Can you imagine Paul saying something like that? Anathema, it means to curse something and kick it out. Excommunication. Out you go. Go. Leave. Can you imagine that? That's unreal. It truly is. Paul said, you're cursed. Even if an angel from heaven, well, Paul didn't know it at the time, but these Kundalini spirits are angel specialists. They are specialists in angels. They love angels. They love to manifest angels. They love to make angels appear in your dreams, in your room, visions of angels. They're all over the place. Some prophetic see angels that are 100 feet tall. Others of them see them as a foot tall. All of them are familiar spirit visions. Kundalini spirits cause trips to heaven. And they cause trips to hell. And these are demonic visions that are as real as you touching your hands. They seem as real as anything in this world. They also cause fake healings. For example, if a spirit in your body is causing an illness and someone prays for it, the Kundalini spirit will give you a fake healing. The demon will simply back off temporarily, giving the person an illusion that they've been healed because they feel better or they have less pain or the pain is moved. After the service, after they get home, after they go back to work, after they go back to their lives, boom, there it is. It comes back. It's a fake healing. I saw several of those fake whole demonic healings in Todd Bentley's revival in Lakeland, Florida years ago. People were getting healed. They felt better on stage. Later on in the crusade, you saw they were back to normal. The demon simply backs off, releases the symptoms that they were causing. Then later on, the demon reattaches and moves in. And the person is in chronic pain again, or they're limping again, or they've got whatever it is. These spirits are enormously intelligent. They are enormously bright. And they have fooled people in our society, powerful Christians who have great giftings, who have tremendous intelligence, who have good ministries, and who are good ministers. For example, in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, Paul says, there are false apostles and deceitful workers transforming themselves into apostles of Christ. Yeah. He says, don't worry about that, because even Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. So it's no great thing that his ministers are transformed into angels of light. I hope I'm not blowing anybody's mind here, but the deception in the church is scary. And I can attest to it, because I was on the front lines on it and have been on the front lines of it since 2005, when God opened my eyes to see what these Holy Spirit fakers are. They fake the Holy Spirit. They give people sensations. They take you in a vision to the courts of heaven. They tell you about seven mountains we're all going to be conquering. And it goes on and on and on. False doctrines flooding through the church. Fake doctrines. People jumping around like they're on fire. These demons are so intelligent and so smart. They're able to fool the most powerful of all ministers. I mean, you could take somebody like Kenneth Hagin, who was a super anointed man of God in the early days. This guy was literally amazing. He had tremendous ability to read and teach the word, had a tremendous anointing for all kinds of things. Later on in his life, when he got old, these Kundalini spirits tricked this guy and started infesting his churches. He started to have people jumping around with insane St. Vitus dances, people falling around on the floor like tuning forks, people flying out of chairs, hysterically laughing, rolling up and down the aisles. And he thought it was God. He actually thought it was God. Somebody of his caliber, Kenneth Hagin. Can you imagine that? Well, you can, because these Kundalini spirits are so powerful and so intelligent. They can fake out anybody. Here's how they do it. They invade the church and they look for churches who are hungry for God. And they look for churches that want miracles. They're tired of traditional Christianity. They're tired of denominationalism. And they said, hey, what we want is miracles. We want to see God move. We want to see supernatural move of God. That's what we want. That's what we got to have. Guess what? That's the churches they invade. And that's what they give them. Major league sensations. Major league sensations. Physical sensations. Visual sensations. Auditory sensations. Dreams. Visions. Prophecies. People that have these Kundalini spirits are chronic word givers. They run around the churches. Hey, I've got a word for you. God gave me a word to give to you. And people don't know that the Bible requires that every word be confirmed with two or three witnesses. They don't do that. They just accept the person because they see them as credible. And if they give them a word, they just accept it. Well, the deception is absolutely enormous. Check out 2 Corinthians chapter 11, if you would. Paul says, I fear for you. I fear lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve. That's the Greek word exopateo. It means to completely and totally deceive. Eve was listening to the devil talk to her, and she got caught. She was completely fooled. But the greater sin was Adam, because Adam was not fooled. Eve was tricked into believing what the serpent told her. Adam was not tricked, and he ate the apple anyway. Therefore, to whom much is given, Jesus said, much is required. And Paul said, lest by any means the serpent that beguiled Eve through his subtlety. And this is where we're at here with these Kundalini spirits. They're so subtle. They're so sneaky. Nobody catches them. As the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety, so your minds should be corrupted. That was mistranslated. The Greek word for minds there is nama. It means thoughts. So that your thoughts should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ. These demons are thought invaders. Hey, here's a question board. We can get deep spiritual insight from God. It's kind of like an Ouija board. You move this thing around. It's a Bible instead of a... Here's some Christian cards to determine your future and give you a prediction of your ministry. Here, we'll see what God's... Let's let God speak to us through these cards. This is how smart these things are. They are thought invaders. They invade the person's thoughts and drift them over to the world of familiar spirits. Kundalini spirits are a offshoot of familiar spirits. And familiar spirits are the worst kind of demons. They can cause miracles. They are the smartest of all the demons. They do all the witchcraft in the world. They do all the church witchcraft. They run all the church denominations. They created all the false religions. To be able to create a religion as complicated as Scientology, Hinduism, and so on, think about the intellect or intelligence you would have to create those religions. I mean, it's intelligence that human beings are unfamiliar with. We don't know what kind of level of intelligence these demons are. They're that smart. I personally know several ministers of the gospel who are very intelligent people, very good people with good hearts and who love the Lord, deceived by these spirits. And they will not listen to me or anybody else. They believe it. They believe it. It's frightening. And these spirits from Africa through Toronto Blessing, through the rest of the country, up into Canada, they're spreading all over. They're everywhere. These demons are corrupting Christianity. And they are a forerunner to the rise of the false prophet coming in just a few short years. He'll be here during the tribulation to set up the planet Earth to be taken over by the Antichrist. He's the main figure of human history, the false prophet. People believe the Antichrist because of the false prophet. There wouldn't be an Antichrist if it wasn't for the false prophet, because he has all the miracles and he has the ability of major deception. He will be the most powerful spiritual person that ever lived on the planet. Worse than Nimrod. Yeah, that bad. Worse than Nimrod. This is the man who is going to hand the planet over to the Antichrist. And when that happens, the planet Earth is in trouble it has never seen before. In fact, that's exactly what Jesus said. There will be tribulation worse than any time in human history. Can you imagine that? That's going to be amazing. How's that going to happen? Spiritualism. Kundalini spirits taking over the church. Familiar spirits taking over the rest of the planet. Everybody going spiritual. Everything is spiritual. And it's going to spread everywhere, in particular over social media. And as you know, in Revelation, it's the false prophet that turns the icon in the Greek, but it turns the statue of the Antichrist, and it starts talking and moving. Oh, well, that's easy to do. Are you kidding me? AI will be doing that. It's going to look real. I saw a video not too long ago of Barack Obama, and he was saying the stupidest stuff you ever heard in your life. I mean, stuff you knew that Barack Obama would not say. I mean, it was just ridiculous. It looked exactly like him, and it was his voice. It looked and sounded exactly like Barack Obama. We're already into AI. We're already into deep fakes. If you see something on Instagram or Facebook, there's a fairly high possibility, not a probability yet, but it's getting close, that that person talking is not that person. It looks like them. It sounds like them. It's not them. And it's already happening. AI is just beginning to take over. It's just beginning to infiltrate our society. AI now, in fact, 60 Minutes had a show just, a few weeks ago? A couple, two, 3 weeks ago? They had a segment on bilking seniors out of their money. And what happens is people are using AI to call elderly people up, impersonating their grandson or their granddaughter who's in a trauma situation and needs $10,000 ASAP. And it sounds exactly like the grandson or the granddaughter. I mean, we've entered a world now, and it's going to get exponentially worse, where you cannot practically trust anybody or anything. It's all happening under the authority, under the supervision of Satan himself. He's putting this thing together through fallen angels and through familiar spirits all over the planet Earth. It's happening right now as I'm speaking to you. I go over all this stuff on my radio show, 10 a.m. every morning, Monday through Friday, at 7:30 and 7:15 in the evening. By the way, I'll also be on AM 1100 starting next week. Every Sunday morning at 8 o'clock, I'll be on the radio here in Maricopa County. But these are the kind of things I talk about on the radio program. But today, I wanted you to be aware. Number one, if somebody gives you a word, the Bible says in the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word is to be established. You never accept a word from someone. Never do that. Number two, do not, as Paul told Timothy, do not let somebody lay their hands on you if you don't know who that person is, because they can transfer a spirit, a kundalini spirit, into you. They can transfer a kundalini spirit into you. Quick story. I went to a service in Northeast Phoenix, and there was a famous prophetic preacher going to be there, and I thought, well, I'll go up there and take some notes. So I did. I went up there with a friend of mine, and I sat in the back, had my notepad out. I was taking notes on the service. This guy was a pretty good speaker. He was pretty interesting. He was about in his 40s. His wife was with him. So they had an altar call after he was done speaking. And they lined people up from one end of the room to the other. Okay. And I was amazed at the power in that service. This guy and two or three other women were praying for each person. And they were just falling on the ground and going into seizures. Some people in the service were doing crunches. You know, they were jumping forward and doing their ab work and doing the hose. Ho, ho. And I mean, it went up and down the line. I couldn't believe it. Well, one thing in the service really hurt me. I had a friend of mine, a beautiful woman of God who I personally knew, and I knew she was a powerful Christian. I knew she loved the Lord. She was legit, 100% legit. I knew her, and she had fallen on the ground when this guy came by and was snorting. It sounded like a pig. My friend was on the ground snorting like a pig. That's when I knew. That's when I knew, hey, these things are the bomb. An afterthought to that story, you're not going to believe this. Two or three weeks later, a big fight broke out on the pastoral staff, and that church disintegrated, disappeared, and was gone overnight. It just wiped out. What am I trying to say? The Holy Spirit lives in your spirit, man. He does not use your soul to manifest his presence. He uses your spirit man. He works through your mind and your free will. Kundalini spirits hide in your brain, and they put thoughts in your mind, as Paul said, and they manifest good feelings, happy feelings out of your soul. That's what palm readers do. That's what witch doctors do. That's what seances do. The demons attack your mind using your soul and your emotions. The Holy Spirit is in your spirit, man, and he operates through your free will and your mind to perform his miracles, his giftings, and his fruit. Okay? don't let anybody touch you at church anymore. It's too dangerous. You don't know where that person has been. You don't know who they have been with. Okay? Who they have been with. All right? Don't go into a group prayer meeting where everybody's praying for each other. You know, everybody's standing around in a group and they're all putting their hands on each other. They're going through a fire tunnel, a prayer tunnel. Everybody goes through and everybody prays for them. And you can see them manifesting in the tunnel. Half of them don't do anything. They just stand there like bricks walking through. The other half are jerking and flying all over the place. Oh, and they think it's God. That's the key. These spirits are so intelligent. They're so smart. They make you think it's God. And wouldn't you normally think it is God? Because it feels good. The sensations are good. The body temperature changes. Feel good, right? Oh, it's sensational. Who doesn't want to see a glory cloud? Oh, wow. Who doesn't like that? I mean, what's wrong with a bleeding statue? It's all good. Well, what's wrong with it is these demons are manifesting their power. They're manifesting their power. And they're tricking people and they're infesting them with terminal illnesses that pop up later. Their favorite terminal illness is cancer. Their second favorite one is fibromyalgia. These familiar spirits love to give people cancer. And the church and the ministers and the apostles and the prophets all pray for this person and they die anyway. Why? The person doesn't need a healing. They need deliverance from familiar spirits, kundalini spirits. These demons, I've noticed, love fibromyalgia. You know the best way to get fibromyalgia? Gold dust. Minerals on the floor. Remember those little diamonds that used to come out of thin air? That's how powerful they are. They're capable of performing miracles. Miracles. I went to a service one time where some guy, some minister, was leaking oil. I know you think I'm making some of this stuff up. I'm telling you, I saw it. I mean, it was pouring out of the dude. Oil. Yeah, oil. I mean, he could have changed the oil in his car. There was so much of it. And he was going to pray for the sick that day. And I thought, whoa, this is interesting. I'm going to watch this. I don't know, 10, 12, 14 people came up. Not one of them got healed. Nobody got healed. This guy that was leaking oil didn't even have the kundalini power that the other guy I had saw, where they fall down and then they start jumping around and howling and vibrating, tuning, forking. He didn't have that. He was praying for people and they just stood there. Nothing happened. And he had oil pouring out of him. And people were going up there thinking, wow, if this guy's got that kind of God anointing with oil pouring out of his shirt, look at him, he's soaked. Then I'm going to get healed today. Nobody got healed in the service. It was literally incredible. And I remember my heart went out to these poor people. They so wanted somebody to help them. And boop, the kundalini stepped in and said, hey, I'll help you. Here's some cancer for you in 15 years. There you go. You're okay. You like to go on a trip to heaven? You want to go see hell? You do? Okay. Kundalini's got no problem with that. Want a vision? Would you like to have a vision? You would. If you'd like to see these kundalini spirits in action, and you want to hear all about them, it's so easy to do. You need only do two things. It's easy to do. You can go right to the internet, right to YouTube. Sid Roth and the Elijah List. Just go right there after I'm done, if you don't believe me. Almost every single guest on Sid Roth, I flip through that show all the time. Every time I'm around on TV, I check and see if Sid Roth is on. Because I want to see what's the next Kundalini thing coming down the pike. So I use Sid Roth just to keep up with it. Elijah List, give you a full update on everything. I almost fainted one day. I was watching a show with the great preacher Mario Marilla. He's 100% the real deal. He doesn't have any Kundalini. He's a powerful man of God. He was on this show with three other ministers, and one of them was this lady who had either pink or green hair. She looked like she was like my age, you know, old. And she went on to say that she goes to heaven every week, literally heaven, every week. And sometimes she goes up there and Jesus and Jehovah are golfing. They like to golf. One trip she went up there, she saw Santa handing toys out to children in Santa Land. There's a Santa Land in heaven. And I felt so sorry for Mario Murillo because he was on there with her and two other ministers, and he never said a word. The guy never said a word. And I'm sure it's because he didn't want to disrespect the other two ministers and didn't want to cause a giant ruckus. But later on, a few months later, he came out with it about these Kundalini spirits, and he started writing about them. Before that, just a few months ago, he never touched it. He didn't understand. I don't think he really understands it. He hasn't had the experience I've had with it to see the inner workings of how these demons work. He doesn't know that. But he knows something's really wrong. No kidding. Santa in heaven? Did you know the tooth fairy's in heaven? You know that? Wow. Folks, the false prophet, the monster, is coming. I think he's only a few years away. I truly do. I think, even though I'm old, I think I might have a shot at seeing something. Rapture, tribulation, something like that. I think it may be that soon. And so, with the false prophet on the horizon, spirituality and spiritualism will dramatically accelerate over the next few years. It's going to go right over the top. And there's going to be so many spiritual distractions from the basics of the gospel. Paul called it the simplicity of Christ. It's so simple. You need to be forgiven. You need your body healed. You need the demons out of your body. You need to renew your mind. You need to then start blessing others. Boom, hit it. The simplicity and the beauty of the living Christ. It can't be compared to anything and never will. There is no such thing as another Jesus. It's a familiar spirit. It's a demon. They're faking you out. Bleeding statues are not from God. Hello? Oil pouring out of a guy's face and nobody gets healed? Are you kidding me? That's a red flag. Nobody saw it. I was the only person in the meeting who saw what was going on. During the Lakeland revival, 90% of the group, number one ministers of the prophetic movement, 90%, could have been 95, let's say 90% to be fair, were at that one service the night they ordained Todd Bentley the apostle of the entire movement, the entire prophetic movement. He was ordained as the number one apostle. And that was a few weeks before he ran off with his girlfriend and left his wife and kids. What was happening there? That was God telling the people, I love you. Open your eyes. I love you. Open your eyes. You're being deceived. You're being deceived. They're tricking you. These are familiar spirit manifestations. I'm not sending you oil and gold dust and glory clouds. I'm not sending you that stuff. It's not there. The demons are doing it. The demons are doing it. If you have picked up Kundalini spirits from a Pentecostal or a charismatic church that you attended, you can be delivered. We have two Zoom services every week, two of them, okay? Tuesday nights at 6:30 Pacific time, Wednesday night at 6 p.m. Pacific time. You can be delivered on the Zoom broadcast. If you're in Maricopa County or Arizona, or you're in California, come visit us. We get people coming over from California all the time. Come on to the services Thursday and Friday nights at 7 o'clock. Come in for a counseling appointment. Call the ministry line, 602-636-5800. If you're in the prophetic movement right now and you see all kinds of hidden sin through the movement that shouldn't be there, if you see a lot of weird manifestations, people vibrating like, hallelujah, Lord, and they're shaking, rattling, and rolling, those are Kundalini spirits. They've probably transferred into you. And the blood of Christ is able to deliver you from these monstrous deceivers. Because Satan is behind it all, because he is, as it says in Revelation, the deceiver of the entire world. You need to send me an email. You need to call. You need to come to the service. Something. You need to zoom it out Tuesday or Wednesday to get these things out of you. Because as I told you, I know this for a fact. I've seen it over and over and over for years. These Kundalini spirits, for some reason, love cancer and joint disorders, fibromyalgia, arthritis, stuff like that. They seem to specialize in that. I don't exactly know why, but that's what I've seen. Okay? Send me an email, mike@hardcorechristianity.com. I'll send you the information for the Zoom. I'll send you the ID code, and I'll send you the password Tuesday or Wednesday night. Please. If you went to a prophetic church, you didn't know it. You just went there with a friend. Maybe you went there for the first time. Just check it out. And somebody wanted to pray with you. They had an altar call. And you went down there. You were innocent. You weren't doing anything bad. You just want somebody to pray for you. You go down to the front. Somebody comes by and speaks a word over you and then puts their hands on you. Oh, my God. You picked up a transfer. You're in big trouble. And you're going to go down later. Hopefully this message will get out and be shared with people who have these spirits, and they will come for help ASAP, because the false prophet is, in my opinion, just around the corner. He's only a few years away now. I mean, this thing's rapidly wrapping up. And you need to be free, and you need to set others free.